Good evening, everyone. My name is Terry Sullivan, and this again this evening, once again, is the Inside Corner. The topic this evening is the 100-year-old rivalry between Hinsdale Central High School and LT. You heard me right. Over 100 years. I bothered to research this. I mean, that would be good of me, wouldn't it? I bothered to research this, and I looked back in old yearbooks, and the oldest contest between the two schools dates to 1898. Wow, that's a long time. In those days, they called it the Suburban League. It was comprised of Hinsdale Central, LT, Riverside, Brookfield, Oak Park, River Forest, Evanston, and Waukegan. And it was a powerhouse conference. But you know as well as I do that there has always been some sort of undefined tension between the two schools. And so what we have done this evening is we have asked student athletes from both schools to come here to explain to us how, in their experience, did this rivalry grow? How did they see it? When did it begin for them? What does it mean to them, if anything at all? And what are the workings of it? Is there real tension, or is it just so much neighborhood hype? We'll find out. I have with me this evening experts on the topic. Namely, to my left, this is Jim Thompson. He is a senior at Hinsdale Central High School. He's a linebacker on the football team and a forward on the basketball team. And next to him, a teammate of his, this is Mike Johnson, also a senior. He's an offensive lineman on the varsity football team and plays first base in the varsity baseball team. So they have had their confrontations. Notice how we're almost compelled to use aggressive terminologies when we talk about the two schools. I immediately went to the word confrontation. It should have been just matchup or something more neutral. I'm doing it myself. I'm hyping the issue. But they have had their experiences playing LT, and they probably have had those experiences even before their freshman year in travel baseball or travel football or community interactions. We'll see. We'll see what this is all about finally after 100 years and more, someone is openly discussing the rivalry between Hinsdale Central and LT. Wow. Okay. Thanks for coming, by the way. And this is LTTV, and you are in enemy territory.
Yeah.
But nonetheless, thanks for coming. It took a little bit of social courage to agree to do this. And I appreciate it, and everyone listening appreciates it also. Okay, I want to ask the both of you, and volunteer, just speak up. First of all, about your allegiance to your school. How real is that feeling for you, your loyalty and attachment to Hinsdale Central? How real is it? Can you explain that for me? Do you feel strong attachment to Hinsdale Central?
I mean, personally, I definitely do. There's a ton of tradition when it comes to the school, mm-hmm. you know, for example, being the horn ceremony, you know, a week before our first game, we'll get the horns on our helmets. That's been going on for hundreds
really?
Of years.
Oh, really? That's a ritual, huh?
Yeah. So, I mean, just being a part of that, just a sense of, you know, loyalty and pride in your school.
So you learn that right away. I never knew that. Are there guys in the football field without the horns on their helmets?
Well, no, there's not, but... Funny story, if you don't play well, you get them taken away. So
whoa.
Yeah.
Does that happen?
It has happened. Sophomore year, it happened to us.
It happened to the team?
Yeah, our class.
Our class.
Your class?
Yeah.
Had it happened before in your memory? Or did anyone tell you it hasn't happened for 10 years and then you guys are the...
No,
but the upperclassmen at the time, you know, they were like, yeah, that's a big deal. You get them taken away. So
you received the horns on your football helmet.
Yeah.
And this is a passage, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
This says you're fully membered. I mean, you're a full member, mm-hmm. full-fledged Red Devil, right?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so this ceremonious awarding of the horns is one thing that gives you the impression that you have a sense of belonging. And this is an important thing. This is, as you said, this is a big deal.
Yeah,
okay.
It is.
Anything, any passage like that, initiation rite like that before your sophomore year that gave you the impression that you are in a very exclusive group?
I'm trying to think, but I mean, just from day one, you know, we have our freshman coach. He's been around for 25 years, so he's seen all these teams go through. He's you know, seen how the program runs its course and all that. Mm-hmm. So he's got a ton of experience when it comes to that, and he really put an emphasis on pride and loyalty to the, you know, the team.
Right.
So
you get it when you're a freshman.
Yeah.
This indoctrination.
Yeah.
It amounts to so much positive propaganda.
And yeah.
Freshman coach is really getting a mindset for you that mm-hmm. you're Red Devil, and
yeah.
that's a big deal.
Yeah.
Did you play travel football before you went to Hinsdale?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I played Hinsdale Falcons, which is for most kids who go to the public schools, and then
yeah.
Mike played it for St. Isaac's.
Yeah, I played sub Catholic League.
Okay.
So kids who go to LT like St. Cletus, so I know a few guys from St. Cletus.
Okay, so you had interaction with LT guys before?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Definitely.
You know all these guys.
Yeah.
And what was that relationship like? Was it real adversarial?
Well, I can give a few examples.
Yeah.
All-Stars, 9 through 12. First time I experienced playing LT in a tournament was, well, not LT, Western Springs at the time, but
yes.
Feeder Town.
Yeah.
So was 9-year-olds, and I mean, those games used to be, you know, the parents are going at each other, the
okay.
kids are playing hard, it's
good.
Just a great atmosphere, it's real
competitive. I'm glad he said that.
Yeah.
The parents were going at each other.
Yeah.
Because maybe that's where this all begins, you know?
Maybe.
Maybe back in 1898.
Yeah.
The first time the two schools met. The promotion of the rivalry was really done at a level other than the student level, the athlete's level. So the parents were going at it.
Yeah.
In your travel football program.
Baseball. Yeah.
Doesn't matter, does it?
No.
The sport. Doesn't
yeah.
matter what the sport is. Could be chess team, it wouldn't matter.
Yeah.
We want to know about the rivalry. When you say that, what do you mean they were going at it?
I mean, you know, you got parents going, come on, Charlie, park one of that guy's Corvette, stuff like that, just
oh, yeah.
going back to each other, you know, stuff like
it was the old rap on Hinsdale,
yeah,
the multi
yeah.
guys, yeah, yeah.
So, yeah, I mean, that pumped us up enough
yeah.
to beat them, but,
yeah.
You know.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it's pretty, I mean, being a 9-year-old, you're not really used to, you know, that kind of atmosphere, yeah. you know, when you get to the high school level, it's just kind of.
So you remember yeah. distinctly.
Yeah.
As you were an 8th grader in this Western
I was baseball? 9 years old.
9 years old, excuse
yeah.
me. You remember from 9 years old.
Yeah.
That some adult made a remark referring
yeah.
to the socioeconomic differences.
I thoroughly remember that.
Between the two communities.
That was the first time I was exposed to that kind of
wow.
stuff with the rivalry.
That's really interesting, Mike.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's where you get it, you see?
Yeah.
That's where you get it. Some guy says, go park your Corvette. Is that what it was?
Go it was park. Go park that ball in the Corvette.
Go
and, like,
park
hit
that
one
ball.
Because the parking lot was right in right field,
yeah.
so.
Wow. Well, there are obvious socioeconomic differences between the two, but I don't know how that relates to a sporting event. I mean, you still have to be good at the game,
yeah.
no matter what you drove up in.
Mm-hmm.
But that theme is just hammered on.
Yeah,
you know, mm-hmm. that the Hinsdale guys have all the wherewithal.
Yeah, it's
they got it all.
Yeah,
and LaGrange is the slums, and it's. Haves against have-nots.
Yeah.
That's been going on for decades.
Yeah, yang versus yang kind,
yeah.
of, kind of thing.
Do you believe that? Do you believe it's this rivalry has that kind of socioeconomic aspect to it? Or is that another issue incidental to the rivalry?
I mean, I think it plays a part in it,
yeah.
but at the same time, we're getting that every single week from every single team we
yeah.
play.
Yeah.
So, like, we're used to
true.
That. So
yeah.
maybe it fuels some of the LT fans,
yeah.
some of those guys, but as far as we're concerned, like, we get it every week because
yeah.
every team, it's going to give them a little bit of an edge.
Yeah.
But, I mean, it definitely plays a part, but I think there's more to the LT Hinsdale rivalry than just that.
Okay, now imagine this, Jim and Mike, imagine this. In 1898, for kind of, let's go forward, let's say 1910, 1920, Hinsdale is and LaGrange are still basically rural areas, right?
Mm-hmm.
So the beginning of this rivalry probably had nothing to do with socioeconomics because there wasn't any development in the communities. So somewhere along the line, the stereotypical image of Hinsdale as rich and spoiled and having more than they deserve, and LaGrange being the hillbilly community, you know, that develops sometime later, because in both communities' origins, this was farm area, really, mm-hmm. farm area, mm-hmm. Grau Mill and all that, farms out at Solosi Edison Cadillac, that was all farm, or farms all around us. So in 1898, it wasn't about socioeconomics, it wasn't beat the rich kids. It wasn't about that. It had to be just about proximity, mm-hmm. right? You know, because mm-hmm. we're right next door.
Yeah, that's what I think it was, personally.
Okay, I should ask this basic question. Do you feel that LT is your rival?
From a tradition standpoint and history, definitely yes. Mm-hmm. But with the upcoming Glenbar West team, that yeah. whole entire program, okay. up on the rise, being a dominant team, yeah. that's become a huge game for us, mm-hmm. but LT's always a big game for us, no matter yeah. what the sport.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
you keep playing in soccer, and it's go to the LT Hinsdale Central soccer game, yeah. go to the LT Hinsdale Central bowling meet. So.
Yeah, the emotional aspect is more intense, huh, do you think?
Mm. Yeah, definitely.
But you know full well that Glenbard's the team to beat.
Yeah, I mean, I think that has more to do with just their success lately, and as much as they're our rival for football, because we want to get a piece of them, I think that goes without saying for every team in the conference, because everyone would like to beat them.
Yeah, LT's, you have to beat them.
Yeah, yeah. But LT is still something I think is unique for mm-hmm. us. But then again, at the same time, everyone in our conference hates us because we've got the money and we're the rich kids. So everyone's hating on us, so we got to bring it every week.
Yeah.
What is that all about?
That from freshman year, that's what you get. You know, week one, week two, and so on, all the way through week nine is this team hates you. They hate you. They would like anything to beat you. They would do anything for that.
Based on your advantages.
I'm assuming so.
Yeah, based on their perception that you are advantaged.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's kind of how it is, I guess.
That would make me angry.
It does.
I mean, it gives them an edge, and also gives us a reason, you know, get angry and play with the chip on our shoulder.
Because certainly your parents have done the job wherein you don't feel privileged. You've had to earn what you have. Right?
To some mm-hmm. extent.
Yeah, so and here are people telling you, you got everything, you're spoiled. So there's resentment right there.
Yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And they resent you because they think you have everything. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So that's why we need to discuss this. I don't think, basically, kids in Hinsdale are any different than kids in LaGrange. They do get along. You have friends from LT?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
See that? See? See?
Play baseball with them.
Yeah. You play baseball with them in the summer.
It's all the kids in the neighborhood over that we grew up playing. Yeah. I mean, as much as we played against them growing up before high school, I was on the teams with some of these kids too. So.
Okay, the segment of the society that doesn't get together is the adult level.
Yeah.
Yeah. They don't get together.
No.
But you guys have known each other even before getting over there.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
All right. This year, of course, Hinsdale beat LT. What was the score, by the way?
37-24.
37-23. High-scoring game. Were there any incidents surrounding that game that indicated the intensity of the rivalry?
On the player level or the...
Okay, on the player level. Let's start there.
On the player level, personally, we didn't beat LT at all until that night. So... On the player level, I mean, like I said, we know these guys. I played baseball with them. So going into them, you know, I wish the game good luck. I talked to them the night before. So it was all business in terms of the players. But the students, on the other hand, that got a bit rowdy.
Yeah. I mean, there's nothing out of line or anything other than nothing out like unsportsmanlike or anything like that between the players. But obviously the student sections had their little scuffles.
Yeah, sure.
That's another demographic altogether than the athletes.
Mm-hmm. mm-hmm.
Their perception of it is superficial, right? They're going to see it strictly as the rivalry.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They're not going to see it as the science of the game.
No. It's all about the rivalry. Yeah. It's all about beat LT, beat Hinsdale Central.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So no expressions, no extreme expressions of animosity between the two teams.
Well, we have great amount of respect for each other, but, you know, and that was – first through fourth quarters, I mean, it's a war, but when it's over, you know, you can't change the outcome, so we just go back to how how things were.
It's interesting. The difference, again, in almost all the topics we do, the most recurrent observation, the most recurrent aspect or theme is that there is a difference in the perspective of the kids as opposed to the perspective and behavior of the adults. Comes back to us time and time and time again. Here's what's going to occur now. We've had our introduction to the Hinsdale Central student athletes. We're going to have an LT player come on next and run him through the same questions about the rivalry as he sees it. And then in the last segment of the show, we will put Mike and Jim from Hinsdale together with the LT player, and we will have an open discussion, the two rivaling factions together discussing the topic. So please don't go away. There's going to be a very short break here for public service announcements. My name is Terry Sullivan. This is the Inside Corner. You are watching LTTV. The topic is the Hinsdale Central LT rivalry. Don't go away. Come back. We'll be waiting for you right here. Okay? Thank you. Thanks for coming back. My name is Terry Sullivan. This is the Inside Corner. And the topic this evening is the rivalry between Hinsdale Central and Lyons Township High School, which, by the way, according to our amateur research, goes back as far as 1898 in the old Suburban League. We have already discussed the topic with Mike Johnson and Jim Thompson from Hinsdale Central, both of whom were football players. That was in the last segment. We are now presenting you with another expert on the topic, someone who has lived it, you know. This is Dante Stefanini. He's a defensive end on the varsity football team, and he also has mustered up the courage to come here to discuss this topic in the presence of Hinsdale Red Devils. Whoa. So, you went to Highlands Middle School.
Yes.
Right? Very good school.
Oh, yeah.
Shout out to Highlands.
Go Hornets.
Yes, sir. Did you know any Hinsdale players when you were in middle school?
Yeah, it's actually an interesting situation for me, you know, when we do play Hinsdale Central, because up to sixth grade, I played Western Springs football. I played the Western Springs League, but seventh and eighth grade, I made a switch and I started playing Hinsdale Central, Hinsdale Falcon football, which is almost the feeder program for Hinsdale Central.
Yeah.
Just because, you know, there was a little more personalized coaching. You
okay.
know, my parents thought that I'd learn more, and I'd say that's true. And while I was there, I got to know a bunch of the Hinsdale
sure.
players pretty
they
well.
Were teammates? So
we were teammates at one point, yes.
Oh, how ironic.
Me and Jim over there.
Really?
Yeah.
Jim Thompson, you were teammates.
Yes.
What age?
What's eighth grade.
Oh, gosh. And then you find yourself on the other side of the ball.
Yep.
In the varsity. No, sophomore, freshman. Freshman, sophomore, and varsity.
Mm-hmm.
Did you communicate with Jim your freshman year before the Hinsdale Central game?
Well, actually, that's another interesting thing. I didn't go to Lyons Township for my freshman season. I actually played at Fenwick.
Oh, you did?
Until I transferred. I transferred from Fenwick to LT after the second semester,
okay.
After the first semester.
But were you aware of the rivalry, even though you spent that 1 year at Fenwick? Were
yes.
you aware of this rivalry?
Yes, I had gone to plenty of LT football games before in the past, you know, just as an eighth grader, seventh grader, just something to do on a Friday night, just go see the game. And the Hinsdale Central Lyons Township game was always the biggest
big
turnout.
Time, yeah. Let me ask you just incidentally, beside the topic here, Fenwick's leading rival, would it be Brother Rice, Rita, or Mount Carmel? Their leading rival. Loyola?
Well, actually, I was going to say, when I was there, our biggest game was against Loyola
yeah.
at their place.
Yeah.
And we lost, I think it was, freshman year, we lost 28-14. It was a tough game, but That was definitely the game.
What you felt there, the intensity of that rivalry, was it similar to what you feel at LT with Hinsdale?
I'd say the LT Hinsdale rivalry is a little more intense. Just because that was freshman year and this is varsity. Every game's a big game, but you know, they're just down the road.
Yeah, the
from
proximity.
Us,
so. The proximity. That's a, you know, yes. That's a point. It's a real. It's one that we overlook. The two schools are practically on top of each other. I mean, if there weren't an LT, kids would be going to Hinsdale Central. If there wasn't a Hinsdale Central, LT would be the township school, and they'd be coming here. They're that close. So that proximity.
It definitely adds.
Definitely,
to it.
Yeah. Very good, Dante. It definitely adds to the tension between the two schools. All right, the Fenwick-Loyola thing, you say, even though, but that was at the freshman level.
Yes.
You felt it as a freshman. What you're feeling towards the Red Devils is at the varsity level, which is more serious.
Just exactly, because it matters.
It matters
a little
more
than the freshman level, I'd have to say.
When you were on the Hinsdale Falcons travel football team, right?
Yes.
And all you were surrounded by all these Hinsdale guys. Take any heat about being from Western Springs LT District?
That's the thing. I mean, there's really between the players, nobody poked fun of me. Nobody said, you're white trash. Oh, you're a hillbilly because you're from Western Springs. Yeah, there was none of that because, I mean, we were all teammates back then. So, I mean, that was never an issue for me.
Yeah.
And even now, between the players, there's not a lot of that. That's more of a student.
Yeah. Very good. It's exactly the same thing that Thompson and Johnson had to say. That it's more at the student level,
right,
or the adult level.
I feel exactly. Parents too.
Yeah.
Parents get into
it.
It
is with the kids. But again, if the adults behave in a fashion, the kids will respond to that. You know, they will imitate it.
Mm-hmm.
They will connect to it. Is there any passage right at LT football like they were describing about their horn ritual wherein they're allowed to have the Red Devil horns on their helmets? Is there anything similar to that which for LT football players increases the connection, the allegiance to the school?
Yes, I can't speak for the offense, but on the defensive side of the ball, each week the starters are presented with, this goes back to a tradition at University of Nebraska, called the Black Shirts.
Yeah.
Each week, the 11 starters on the defense would get a black shirt with a skull and crossbones on it, meaning that you were a starter. And I learned about this my sophomore year when I transferred and when I was practicing up with the varsity. And for years, I had always wanted that.
I wanted that
black shirt.
Black shirt.
It really, you know, gave you something to strive for, and it's a real honor when you finally achieve that.
Yeah.
And I think that's something really cool that we've done and that we've done for the past probably 5 or 6 years.
Okay. So there's your mark, your sign of belonging, your passage right, full-fledged membership, and theirs is the horns on the helmet. These things, which I think are impressed upon you as something you need to earn, right?
Yes.
I think that's healthy for growing up. There may be a little bit of a management problem with things like that, so it doesn't get out of hand, doesn't turn into a hazing thing.
No, of course not.
Yeah. But would you agree with me if I were to say those types of rituals intensify the rivalry?
I'm not sure about that. I think it's not meant to intensify specifically the Hinsdale Central LT rivalry, but it's meant to intensify every single game that you play.
Yeah.
It's to show that the skull and crossbones means that you are a bad dude. You are a member of the defense.
Yeah.
You hit people.
Yeah.
You knock them down. You hurt them. And that's just what coaches tried to kind of drive into our
Did you hurt anybody against Hinsdale?
No, not against Hinsdale.
Evidently not.
No. Not against Hinsdale. No. Knew that was going to come up.
Yeah. That's all right, man. That's all right. That's all right. You know, I was in that arena, too, for a long time, much longer than you guys. And I felt that. I felt that tension between the schools.
Definitely.
I felt it. I kept my eye on it so nothing extreme would occur. But I got to the point where I didn't want to lose to Hinsdale. I mean,
you never want to lose.
I didn't want to lose to Hinsdale, but then again, I could go home to a wife and children. You guys had to go back to the neighborhood in the classroom and say, you lost to Hinsdale.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was, that was a rough one, especially with the size turnout we had, but I think that was just, I mean, there's no other way to look at it.
Yeah, I wonder historically, going back these over 100 years of the competitions between the two schools, I wonder in the football category alone, I wonder what the cumulative record is. Wonder, isn't that be an interesting statistic to see that?
Definitely.
I wonder about it.
I'm not quite sure on the exact record between the two schools, but I know that we haven't beat Hinsdale Central 2 years in a row in the past, I want to say 10 years, 11 years.
Yeah.
So.
Well, that's because they have so much more money and more advantage.
Right, of course. that old stereotype.
Yeah, that's the reason. And you're just, you know, you're from the trailer park.
Yeah, what do we know? We're white trash. We're hillbillies.
There's nothing you can do about it, yeah. You're just stuck in that rut, and they got it all.
The fancy cars.
Yeah. Oh, well.
But
I saw two videos.
Yes.
I saw those videos. Mm-hmm. Someone, I've forgotten now who sent them to me. Did you send them to me when I asked you to be on the show? Was it you or was it Leonard Ross? Or?
I'm sure. I think it was Leonard.
Somebody sent them to me, and then I got the one from Hinsdale. I said, uh-oh, this is going to be real good because this is going to be some slam on.
Yeah.
And it turned out I thought it was perfect. I thought it was funny, clever, and it didn't contribute to anything extreme.
This is the Hinsdale
Central version.
Yes.
The tall, skinny guy, blonde dude, he had the red striped pants on.
Yeah, the overalls.
Yeah, it didn't get out of hand.
Right.
They kind of made fun of themselves, talking about, and they had all the cars lined up, you know?
Yeah.
And I thought, well, hey, that's clever, that's good, I like that. And then next thing I know, I'm getting the one from LT. Mm-hmm. And evidently the Hinsdale Central video came out first because the LT individual, the lead person in the LT video, he also had on these pants.
Right, it was more of a response.
Right, it was a response, very good.
Response video.
And I thought it was well done.
Yes.
And those things are healthy.
Yeah, definitely, with no, it wasn't any
But I can tell you,
involved.
I remember years.
It was just good old-fashioned.
I can remember years when certain players from LT went over to Hinsdale Central and burned LT in the lawn using kerosene. I can remember Hinsdale Central's players coming over to LT and spray painting the baseball dugouts.
You know, I have to say that it's, I think, an aspect of the whole vandalism part of the rivalry.
Yeah, yeah.
I'd say that's died down a bit.
Yeah.
And now it's just, you know, just student bodies. Student bodies, you know, we don't like you.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they don't like us.
Yeah.
You know, it's just how it's transferred almost from being all about between the players to now it's really a community thing, or at least a student body aspect plays into it a lot. Mm-hmm. Whereas, I mean, when I saw that video for the first time, I'm going to be honest,
the Hinsdale video?
The Hinsdale video, yes. I thought, the kids at Hinsdale Central even like this kid? I felt as if that the video made them look...
What?
A little pompous, I guess you could say. We're going to drive our most expensive car.
Well, yeah, but they were playing... What they were doing is they were satirizing...
First off, you're not going to find a spot if you drive all your expensive cars.
They were only satirizing what LT has to say about Hinsdale Central. That was their satirical response.
That's true.
Yeah, I thought. maybe I read, maybe I gave them too much grace. But nonetheless, I thought both the videos were interesting, fun. They were fun.
Yeah.
Yeah. They weren't burning things into the grass.
No.
Writing stuff.
Keeping it a little more clean.
Over the years, I mean, here's an example. This is a true story. There is a very powerful personality in Chicago in the judicial system who, when this person was a senior in high school, participated in TPing the entire campus at Hinsdale Central. It was a crew of 20 or 30 kids. They spent hours TPing the entire campus at Hinsdale Central. Took a lot of time and effort and deviousness, and that person's a very mature contributor to our society today, very well respected, and this person confessed to that. And I said, oh my God, even the most rational adult at one time felt the necessity to react to Hinsdale. Yeah, yeah.
Yes. To get back.
Yeah, so fortunately, as you're saying, Dante, it's kind of the extreme behaviors.
I'd say it's died down a bit.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, here's another thing that irritates me. Tell me, when you play certain schools and they think they're your rival, like, I don't know. In baseball, we would play Nazareth or Fenwick, and they played us as though we were their rival. And we never felt that toward those two schools at all. They weren't our rival. Hinsdale Central's our rival.
Right.
Not you guys. But they adjusted their approach to us as though, yeah, LT, we gotta get LT, it's the game of the year. Huh? Game of the year.
Who are you?
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
You guys, we've been playing you guys for 10 years. We've been playing Hinsdale Central in every sport known to man for over 100 years.
Right.
All right. And there's no doubt that the relationship is still very viable, still palpable. You can still feel it, hear it, sense it. And you were feeling it and sensing it, much like they said they were at a very young age.
Yes.
Yeah. Mike Johnson said at 9 years of age, he can remember remarks about LT.
I don't know if I could go that far back, just because I had always planned. My father went to Fenwick, so I had always planned on being a Friar.
Yeah,
I didn't really, you know, get too caught up in the whole Lyons Township Hinsdale thing, frankly, because I didn't necessarily care.
You didn't have that. You didn't have that progressive.
Upbringing.
You didn't have the progressive exposure to it year after year after year. You got it when you were a sophomore.
Yes.
Yeah.
But as you were saying before, there are teams that might think that they're our rivals. I mean, Proviso West, York, just because they're conference teams, they can think what they want. But our real rivals, I mean, everyone in the conference wants to beat Glenbard West just because they're a powerhouse.
Right.
They call themselves the hitters when they're the Hilltoppers.
Right.
It gets under just about every team's skin. Yeah.
So they're the team to beat this year for sure.
Definitely.
And that's where you should be focusing. That's not to mean that you'd have tea parties with Hinsdale Central.
Right.
Yeah. Well, okay. You've heard versions of perspectives from both sides of the ball. The Hinsdale Central perspective on the Rivalry, Dante Stefanini from LT and his perspective on the Rivalry. And now, after a short break, we're going to bring them together and see how they approach the topic when they're in the presence of each other. We're going to take a brief break. Don't go away, please. You're watching LTTV. My name is Terry Sullivan. This is the Inside Corner. We'll be right here waiting for you. Thank you. Hey, well, thanks for coming back. Again, my name is Terry Sullivan. This is the Inside Corner, LTTV. The topic is the Hinsdale Central Lyons Township High School rivalry, which dates over 100 years in the past. A true rivalry that has persisted over decades. While we were off camera, the four of us were discussing the fact that sometimes LT or Hinsdale Central plays another school, and the school approaches the game as though Hinsdale or LT were their chief rivals. And there's something fallacious about that. LT only has one true historical rival, this applies to Hinsdale also, and that is the two schools against each other. It's one of the oldest rivalries in the state of Illinois, perhaps, definitely in the Chicago area, and it's rich in all kinds of history. So I wanted to know how the kids perceive it, how do players perceive it, and the nature of it, and the behaviors that result from it. Just their perspectives in an attempt to define that competitive interaction between the two schools and everything wherein the two schools meet, from math club to badminton, I mean, everything. The Hinsdale Central game from LT is always different, and so with the Red Devils playing LT. It's always different. Okay. So you guys knew each other before high school, mm-hmm. right?
Me and Dante.
Right.
Yeah, you and Dante in particular. You guys were teammates?
Yep.
Yep.
On the Hinsdale Falcons travel football team. Mm-hmm. Dante was a resident of Western Springs.
Right? Indian Park.
But he decided to play football over with Hinsdale, the Hinsdale Falcons travel team. So you guys knew each other from grade school. You did not know Dante.
I did not know Dante.
But you knew LT kids.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
So this is something we overlook, that these kids do, it's a free world, and they have had interactions before they get to LT. Do they flip a switch and become hateful rivals immediately, or is that something that only exists amongst the students and the fans and adults? Have you ever used emotionality as part of your motivation to beat each other? Did you psych yourself up ever once special to play LT or to play Hinsdale Central?
Well, every game you got to get psyched up.
Yeah, I know.
Every game you got to get psyched up.
Yeah, every game there's a ritual of raising the emotionality.
Getting the adrenaline up.
Did you do it special for Hinsdale Central?
I wouldn't say it was special, but this year when the team was walking out, when we played them at home, and we saw our student section, probably the biggest student section we've ever seen. The stands were full, it was packed, it was loud, and it was glorious.
Yeah. Did you guys feel that?
Oh, yeah.
Did you feel it?
We had a lot of...
I remember we walked out and immediately, you know, boo and all that stuff. And nothing gets you more psyched up than getting booed.
Booed, yeah. So,
and then I remember walking by our student section, and our student section just started going crazy. Yeah. And we knew, like, you know, this is a game we're going to remember.
This is special. Yeah, so, yeah, you are. Isn't that the thing of it? Yeah. I'm so glad you're mature. You have that mature outlook, that you knew it was a special moment.
Oh yeah.
And it's something that you're never going to forget. You know, you'll be telling your grandkids.
Yeah.
Yeah. Don't think that's so far fetched. One day you'll be taking your grandchild to a Hinsdale Central game, and maybe it'll be the LT game. And you'll be saying, you know, I played in this game, and I can remember that day, and this happened, and that happened. Yeah. It's an indelible memory, do you think? Indelible memory. Yeah. See that? How powerful these things can be for young people? Very powerful. Yeah. So you told me, Dante, you did not use special emotionality for the Hinsdale Central game?
Oh, no. I did my normal routine.
Yeah.
It's just when I saw our student section, that's what really put it over the top and made it different and made it special.
Yes.
Because, you know, we usually get a crowd. Our student section, our student body is pretty good with getting a crowd to our games, be it hockey, volleyball, basketball, football. But no matter what, the students turn out for the Central game, just like your guys' student body turns out for the LT game.
Do you have in-school prep rallies? In-school pep rally?
We didn't have a pep rally, for, like an organized pep rally or anything, but, I mean, we had, everyone knew what was going on that whole week. There was stuff.
You didn't have an assembly at LT prior to the game?
No, the only time we have a pep rally is homecoming week.
Okay.
Same post, yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
But I think the big thing was those two videos. Like, I don't really, like, same thing with Dante. You know, I did my same routine for the night before, same thing, you know, from week to week, but... Seeing those videos and responses, it was kind of like, oh, yeah, some people might turn out. This might be a big game. And walking out, you know, you realize, like, because it was a cold, you know, wet, and rainy night, so you don't know what's going to happen. You don't know.
Yeah.
But walking out, I mean, that really didn't stop them. So we walked out there, and you see this wave of yellow and this wave of red. Yes. And it's just, it's pretty crazy.
The Gold Rush. Yes. Is that what they call them? What, is there a name for you guys?
Yeah, Red Devil Nation.
Red Devil Nation.
Yeah. It was pretty crazy, even walking out of school.
Yeah.
You know, we got, I got out of school pretty fast that day, but we just started, I just started hearing cheering in the hallways on Friday.
Wow.
On the game. Just,
wow, this is good.
Just,
this is good because that's like, the way it was in the old days.
It was pretty special.
Yeah. I coached through a period of time when kids pretty much didn't care.
That, I think it all restarted last year.
Yeah.
Because we had, I played basketball too, and so last year at our place, the LT student section, their LT student section did have a big reputation, and they still do, and they had, they came out in numbers for that game.
Yeah.
And it really, I mean, we had fans, or kids that came to our game, they had a little bit of a student section, but nothing near what they had. Yeah. And,
it's embarrassing.
And I mean, we still won that game at our place, but the stands, I think, were a little disappointed that they could bring more kids to our school.
Disheartening, isn't it?
So when we got to play them again later that year, we filled up more, I think, more kids than they had at, at their place, and that's kind of where it's took off as far as student sections go. And
it would be disheartening as a player to go out there and find out the opposition has more people.
Yeah. So I think that really revamped the energy for the rivalry.
Yeah. I think when we went over to their place with a big crowd in the Blue Nami, it was called.
Blue Nami?
Blue Nami.
Yeah,
we always
clever.
Make up a clever pun, you know. It's, you know, so clever. But when we went there, I think that really sort of reignited the flame, if you will. And then they came to our place and pretty much matched us. We were a little more spread out, Jim. That's why it maybe looked like you guys had more. But
did any teacher in any classroom at either school hype the game? Did any teacher say anything like, okay, extra credit, anybody brings a ticket stuff from the ball game on Saturday?
We got extra credit for the football team, but it wasn't. It wasn't no teachers, but we have a little bit of a, like our off-season program has got a little bit of an incentive for players that go to other sports games trying to get support going from other sports.
Yes.
So hopefully they'll come out for our games in the fall. And so we got a little bit of incentive for the football guys.
Yeah. This surge in student attendance has had its peaks and valleys over the years. Unfortunately, I've been around long enough to see, I've seen many, a lot of it. In 1970, when LT was undefeated state basketball champions, the field house at LT would be crammed. You couldn't get in. Be over 5,000 people in a building that held 4,500. And then I saw that diminish to where you could shoot a cannon off in place and you wouldn't hit anybody. You know, there's nobody there. And then it got better, and then it kind of sunk, and then it got even much better than that. So this, we need a sociologist to explain to us the student motivation for attending extracurricular activities and supporting their school. I don't quite understand what causes the changes. But there was an era. You went to Fenwick for a year. Did Fenwick have in-school pep assemblies before big football games?
For the homecoming game.
Just for homecoming?
It seems like it's just for homecoming.
Okay. Well, nowadays. There was an era when schools.
It'd be every game.
Every game.
Wow.
Friday. Short schedule, everyone ushered into the gym for a pep rally. And they'd shuttle the football team from one campus to the other to get it to accomplish that. Every Friday.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's pretty awesome.
Yeah, but those days are gone, you know. Because now you can't, kids don't have enough time to go to the bathroom in between classes, let alone go to a pep rally.
Well, Hinsdale South actually does that for us. They call it Beat Central Week. They'll get t-shirts, they'll have a pep rally. They'll have a Hinsdale Central football, Red Devil football helmet with the horns and everything. They'll hand it out to the player or practice player of the day, and they'll just
pound this.
Yeah, they'll just beat the living hell out of this helmet during the week. So,
Do you guys do anything like that? Do you guys have any?
No. Yeah.
No. It's like poor, like the homecoming game.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
You know, it is good coaching, never to place too much emphasis, emotional emphasis, on the opponent. Don't put too much at risk emotionally about an individual opponent. Because if the emotionality is raised to a level that's too high, the tension builds, and performance suffers.
Right, you don't focus on the play.
That's right.
As much as the emotional.
Yeah, when the true the true opponent is the execution of the play, that's hard enough.
Right.
Yeah.
As without having to worry about who's across the ball. Yeah. Particularly in baseball, the premise there is that the baseball is the enemy, not Hinsdale Central. You have to beat the ball, not them. Yeah. So all of this hype. It was more of it in years gone by. It seems like it's increasing now, too. All of that hype comes with a risk. Is it whether or not it will affect the performance of the athletes, have a positive effect, or raise the expectations to a level where kids are just tense and they can't perform as they should? You never felt that way, did you?
No, I love playing in a loud place. I love barely hearing the quarterback, you know, go through the cadence. I think that's awesome. So, I mean, the LT Hinsdale Central game was, like I said, like, crazy atmosphere, which is awesome to play. And I remember maybe it might have been the third or fourth series on offense, and we're going down towards, you know, what street is that? You might know.
47?
Yeah. And there was people all across 47 like that.
Yeah,
you couldn't even see 47th Street.
It's great stuff, isn't
it? Was, and then let alone that, and the entire, both stands are just packed.
Great stuff.
Yeah, it was awesome.
And we should be aware that in small town America, Friday night football is the social event.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And little towns pack places.
Oh, yeah.
We here in sophisticated suburbia sometimes have a hard time getting people to show up.
Unfortunately.
Yeah. Isn't that ironic?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right. So, this is a corny question. I don't know, but I think people want to know. Do you feel like you're friends, you guys?
Well, no, sir.
Huh?
Here, go ahead.
I mean, it's not like I hate these guys, but it's also not like we hang out all the time.
Yeah.
I have no problem with them. I mean, we're just kids.
Yeah, I mean, in that 48 minutes.
We're just high school students.
Yeah.
It's not
Did you hear that? How mature is that? We're just kids.
I mean, in that 48 minutes, I might hate you, but after that, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're
back to normal.
Leave it all on the field.
Yeah.
Leave it all on the field.
You do know that sometime from now, I mean, you're going to go off to college. You're going to make, there are going to be other people in your lives that, you're going to cross paths with other friends. But one day, down the road, you're going to run into Dante. He's going to run into you. And, you know, maybe you'll be married with a kid in the shopping cart, you know, and say, hey, Dante, how you doing, man? Yeah, who else? Jim, yeah, Jesus. Mike, yeah. How you been? Good, yeah. Where you living? Oh, I live in Hinsdale, you know. Mm-hmm. Yeah. How's it going? You might have my basement flooded last week. It was a disaster. The conversation is about the adult concerns, and little of it is a flashback.
Yeah.
I've seen it happen. I've experienced it myself. All of it has been trivialized by the past, by the present and the future. It's all been trivialized, and you see each other as equals.
Right.
Yeah, it happens. It happens. Someday it's going to happen to you guys.
Right.
You run into each other at Mariano's 20 years from now.
Yeah.
The Mariano's are still there.
Yeah. You know, well, college is ahead for you. And you're going to run into a whole new set of rivalries there.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And I wonder if it'll be as memorable as what you've experienced at LT and Hinsdale. I wonder if it'll have the same emotionality. It may have more so, depending on the school you choose. But you have you've had unforgettable experiences. Is that what you're telling me?
Yep.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And there have been no extreme behaviors in your mind? No unsportsmanlike?
Nope.
Okay.
Played pretty clean, leave it all on the field.
All right.
Afterwards, I mean, I saw 20, 30 guys that I knew going through the you know, the end of the game handshake. You know, just that I knew from playing Falcons. Yeah. So, I mean.
And so the consensus amongst the three of you.
In the end, we're all high school kids.
Yeah,
just
very good observation.
Hard.
That you know where you are in your life. You're high school guys. Kids, you're not finished. You're not finished yet. But most of it, of what we're pointing to, is more so between the students than it is between the athletes. Is that.
I'd say
that's accurate.
The hostility. Yeah.
With an occasional interference by some immature adults.
Right. Parents. We know the parents.
Are you out there? Are you listening?
We know the parents get into it.
Yeah. Well, this has been enjoyable. I want to thank you guys for coming over. Thanks, Jimmy.
Thank you.
Michael, my pleasure. Dante, go Lyons.
Thank you.
It's good having you. Really envy your youth and all the fun and all of that.
So more to come.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you're right.
Basketball and baseball.
Yeah, right. Yeah. You've got the rest of the year and so many youthful years left. I want to thank Paul Morehouse and Devin Dakota and Will Wyora. And my director this evening, by and large, was Eric Donnermeyer. And the cable station supervisor this evening was David Carafa. I want to thank all of them so much. My name is Terry Sullivan. This has been the Inside Corner. Thanks for showing up. And I'll be right home, Dolly, okay? I promise.